Hey guys, Wazza here. This is a Sticks and Stones match that we've decided to put up. It's in response to a request, so hopefully you guys enjoy it. I'll be talking a bit about the game type and some techniques you can use to improve your play. Oh, that was a bit of a fail. So for those who don't know, a wager match is a game type where you pay 500 credit points. If you come in the top 3, you win money, and if you come in the bottom 3, you lose the money that you bet at the start. In this particular game type, you use a crossbow, ballistic knives, and a tomahawk, and they're the only weapons you get. Each crossbow hit is worth 100 points. Each stab is worth 25 points, so it takes 4 stabs for 1 crossbow hit, or ballistic knife hit, sorry. And tomahawk doesn't give you any points, but it sets the person that you hit back to 0. So for this reason, it's probably the most frustrating game type there is. I really enjoy it, but so many times I've been playing, coming first the whole time, and then just a few seconds before the end, I get a tomahawk to the face, and my score goes back to 0. Oh, that's a nice double kill there. We got a nice little streak here. So anyway, for that reason, it can be really frustrating, but you shouldn't let it frustrate you. It doesn't even matter that it costs 500 credit points. I mean, it does make you feel a bit better at the end, and it's more rewarding to win. But 500 credit points is easily gotten back in a normal game. So I'll give you a few techniques on how to play this. The first is to keep moving. It's a really bad idea to stay in the open, sight down your weapon, try and shoot someone, and stand still while doing it. Expect to get a tomahawk in the face and a new score of 0 if you're going to do that. The only reason you need to hide is also probably just to reload. So keep moving, unless you need to reload, hide somewhere. And even if you're hiding somewhere, just walk like I did then. Don't just stand still in a corner. The second tip's use ballistic weapons for closer range. I'm not doing that the whole game, but it's a good idea to do that because the reload time in the ballistic weapons is quicker. The stab action is a lot quicker too, so if you stab someone and they're using a crossbow and they miss and you miss, you're likely to get the second stab. Yeah, also if you're using the crossbow and you shoot the ground near you and run into it, you kill yourself, and that also sets your points back to 0. So for that reason, it's probably a bad idea to use the crossbow for close range. The crossbow is mainly for long range, and it's because it slightly arcs less, which means it's easy to lead your target at a longer distance. So the third tip would be to I guess make sure you know where you are. If you're coming first, you kind of don't want to run out in the open where heaps of people are. It increases your chances of being tomahawked, and then you lose all the money that you work so hard to get. Right there, I wasn't sure if he was going to tomahawk, so I dodged out the way. I get really scared at about this point in the game that I'm going to lose all my points, and I really don't want it to happen. Also, if you're in the lead, you want to make use of your tomahawk. It means that you'll, just like that, you'll prevent people from catching up to you. And if you're not that good at using a tomahawk, don't worry, just use your other stuff after you've had a go. But really, it is beneficial to set people back to 0 if you're in the lead. Oh yeah, another thing is, if you shoot someone and you're using a crossbow at close range, they get stuck and they run towards you close enough that you die, you get set back to 0 because it's counted as killing yourself. So that's probably another reason not to use crossbow at close range. That'd be really frustrating if you got that far, like I am now, shot someone, they came running at you, and then you lose. You'd feel terrible. Anyway, this is pretty much it, and thanks for watching. If you want us to do anything else, let us know. We'll try and do it. We'll also stick some other stuff up, like we're looking at doing a Simon Says soon. If you don't know what that is, keep watching. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and rate it, comment and do all that sort of stuff. Look forward to hearing from you. See you around. Thank you very much. See ya.